Welcome to Pax Europiana, this time here from Sarajevo. I'm calling for NATO membership of this beautiful country, and I want it to be also in the European Union, so the EU candidate country status. These are two decisions, they can be easily done by the European Union and NATO allies. It's not very complicated, and obviously there's resistance from the side of the Bosnian Serb leader. And in this video and in many others to come, I will exactly outline how to overcome it. But it's very simple, by introducing the euro, opening the Austrian labor market for all Bosnians, and also a major infrastructure double-digit billion investment package for the missing corridors in all directions, the highway for peace deal, like we did it between Serbia and Kosovo, or we started at least, yeah? And anyhow, much is going on like this, so NATO membership is absolute without alternative, and I would like to have it happen by 2024, and to make this done very fast and to have this place. I'm here at the bridge where the disaster of 1914 and the 20th century has started. It's a very historic place. Here's the museum for the assassination of Franz Ferdinand. There is maybe no more symbolic place in Europe to call for Pax Europiana, for peace in Europe. Peace in Europe secured by NATO. By NATO also for our friends from Ukraine, Georgia, Moldova, and also for Austria. Austria should also join NATO, and the most meaningful process is obviously together with Kosovo and Bosnia, and also then to be a role model for Serbia. Again, I repeat the peace offer I've made now several times at the different locations, that Serbia will get the euro for the recognition of Kosovo, and I also call for Bosnia to recognize Kosovo. That would be obviously very meaningful. And I would say that this should be part of the NATO accession agreement. And I think that is also sealed with the euro, with a major investment package, with the opening of the labor market. I think it is a very good and decent deal. I want to show you some of the Austrian heritage buildings here. Many of them left from the time of the 40 years we were together in one currency, one customs union, one union, all questions, because it was an empire, and I have apologized many times for the Austrian crimes against everybody in the Balkans, which we committed in that time. Now we are the European Union, it's a much more peaceful, and it's a very peaceful, it's actually, I think, a symbol of peace. That's what I think, yeah? Somebody thinks we are aggressive, but we are not. We are, and also NATO, it's a defensive alliance, and to be part of it, it's something very meaningful, I think, for Bosnia. After all the wars and the crises of the last century, I think it would be a very like arriving in the West, in the free world, and that's very meaningful for Bosnia, and people here will live in peace and in harmony, and all, no matter, you know, there are millions of Serbs already living in the European Union, for example in Austria, Germany, and in France and in Belgium. They will live very happily as well in the European Union once Bosnia is a member, and maybe the membership of NATO of Bosnia and Kosovo, and also the EU membership then 2029 of both countries, because, you know, Macedonia and Albania should already join 2024. It will lead to a change in Serbia towards the free world, because unfortunately Vucic has now fully gone into the Russian world in a kind of authoritarian, brutal, kind of mixed system. I would even call it gone fully over to the wrong side, to the dark side. And he is in this line of the people who committed this crime. Yes, that's the thinking of Serb nationalists destroying the West, and on the ashes of the West, a better world, a Serbian world, will be constructed. And when you see how much misery and disaster was brought over the world by this decision to kill Franz Ferdinand in order to explode the Austrian Empire, and it worked in some ways, but the misery brought over all people of the Balkans, all Europeans, the whole world, it does not, certainly not outweigh the fact that for some time a very miserable Yugoslavia was then reality, where the Serbs from day one were dominating the rest, suppressing Kosovo, Macedonia, Montenegro, Bosnia brutally, and doing ethnic cleansing and genocide from day one. And they have continued in some form of variation with suppression, a bit less than from 65 to 1988, in this period of 22 years where they were under American tutelage, but it was a disaster. Yes, here, this is a historic place. I can just say I'm very happy that I made the decision to come to Sarajevo in the winter of 2021. I will make a lot of videos. I will brief you and show you the city as it is. I will show you the places of history and talk and walk you for a better Europe. That's the mission of Pax Europiana, and I will do that this morning. Thanks a lot for listening. More to come from Pax Europiana. Bye from Sarajevo.